Horror, they shout. Horror.
Bless. That's that. Should we get some weather with the lovely Louise? She's back again. Hello, Louise.
Hello there. Well, I think we might all have to stay indoors in the southeast and read a good book for the start of the weekend. It's going to be cold and wet, unfortunately. Not a bad end to the day. A few scattered showers still around this evening. Not particularly pleasant down in Plymouth at the moment. This was around half an hour ago. And you can see all the cloud heading in a southwesterly direction. So the showers last to clear from here. But a beautiful clearance already in the along that east coast and into the northwest of Scotland. Here, the best of the sunshine to end the day. Now, overnight tonight, we still keep one or two isolated showers through the north of England, dotted around Wales and the southwest. Elsewhere, a cloudy night to come, but chilly in one or two spots, lows generally of around 5 to 6 degrees. But we start off with a lot of quiet weather to encounter, with the exception really across the far south of Wales, where we still could see a few patchy showers first thing in the morning. Relatively dry and bright, some sunny spells for Northern Ireland here, but still that northeasterly wind. So on exposed coasts of Scotland will feel quite raw, but it will be a cloudy, largely dry start for many. Now, as we push into the north of England again, along those North Sea coasts, the wind's still quite a feature. That's going to make it feel on the chilly side, but it's a dry start for many, maybe even some glimpses of brightness along the north and Norfolk coast. If you're travelling to London first thing in the morning, it's going to be a cloudy but dry, quiet start here, 7 degrees the high first thing. Now, as we push further south and west, we will have a little bit of patchy rain. Some of it could be quite heavy from time to time to clear away from the southwest. It will continue to do so, allowing for the cloud to thin and to break, and the best of the sunshine perhaps into Scotland and along those North Sea facing coasts, eventually brightening up across the Midlands and the southeast as well. Keep a close eye on that rain in the North Sea. I'll come on to that in just a moment. Temperatures generally around 10 to 14 degrees, but the winds will remain. In fact, if anything, become more of a feature towards Friday and into Saturday. It's a northeasterly direction coming in off the North Sea, so cold source for this time of year. That's going to make it feel quite raw. We should have around 13 or 14 degrees. That's average for May, only we're looking at around 7 to 9 degrees for the start of Saturday, and that is going to feel pretty disappointing. On top of all of that, we've got some rain as well that's moving in off the North Sea across England and Wales. So it's going to be cold, wet and windy for the capitals really during Saturday. Drier and brighter to the north, and on Sunday it looks like we could see a bit of improvement with 14 degrees and some sunny spells. More details from me later on.